Hey y'all, it's Samantha, and Annie's not with me today, but welcome to Stuff Mom Never Told You, a production of iHeartRadio. Yeah, y'all, like I said in the introduction, Annie is out. She is missing a very important component, the internet. Yes, downfalls of working from home. We do have to rely heavily on the internet. And unfortunately, it just didn't work out for Annie today. I miss her. Yeah, I just miss her. And today we are talking about Indigenous activists from Latin America for our latest Feminist Around the World. And we're celebrating Indigenous Peoples Day as well as Hispanic Heritage Month, which is still happening as we record this episode. I guess I'm recording it by myself. Aww. But with all that celebrating that is happening, we are actually talking about the amazing works of Colombian ecologist Angela Maldonado. And Maldonado's work has been a fierce battle with some big players. And some have actually called her the guardian of the Amazons. She has been a force when it comes to protecting the land and the creatures that inhabit it. She is what many would picture when it comes to being an environmental activist, someone who not only studied the land, but truly watched over it to protect and fight for the lives of the many inhabitants. She even has a quote about how these lands, as an Indigenous person, you know that these lands will either accept you or reject you, and she feels very home there. She actually first visited the rainforest more than 20 years ago and was deeply affected by what was happening to the environment. And immediately started focusing her education to advocate for the inhabitants and the sources there. In 2003, she was able to get permission to live in the Amazon by the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia, which is a guerrilla group involved with the Colombian conflict and has been working to protect the lands. Her story has traveled far and has even brought a lot of danger her way, including a lot of death threats. But she still pushes forward. Her work has included conservation work through her NGO, Fundación Entropia, as well as working with animals and rescuing animals, essentially. Living in Leticia, a remote area on the borders of Colombia, Brazil, and Peru, she has spent more than 20 years recording, documenting, and defending the forest. According to a 2022 Civil Rights Defenders article, quote, Maldonado is head of the environmental organizations in Tropica, located in the Colombian town Leticia by the Amazon River. The organization works against the illegal trafficking of wildlife and conducts educational programs for indigenous communities. In a new project together with civil rights defenders, Entropica has now started to educate high school children about their human rights and how to stand up against injustice and corruption. The goal is to create a better tomorrow for both the students and society at large. With all of this comes a lot of risk. Here's another quote from that article. Colombia is one of the deadliest countries for activists. This article came out, I believe, in 2022. Last year, at least 145 community leaders and rights defenders were killed in the country. And Helia herself has received death threats due to her activism. And in 2019, she got a secure temporary relocation through Civil Rights Defenders Emergency Fund. Working to protect human rights and the environment comes with a huge risk. She even talked about not having children in fear that she would be murdered for her work. So a lot of things to consider. Her works have also included fighting to stop the trafficking of night monkeys, which she discovered was happening illegally for malaria research. In 2014, she was able to win a lawsuit against the company, the Colombian Ministry of Environment, and the regional environmental authorities, setting a precedent to protect these species and much of the other wildlife there. And she's continued to persist, working constantly to better her community and the world. She has worked to mentor the next generation of activists as well, not only to carry on her work, but to empower them as well. She told the Civil Rights Defender, quote, the Amazon region is a black hole of corruption, smuggling, and impunity. We leave nothing for the younger generation. There is an increase in drugs, child prostitution, and children dropping out of school. In this project, we want to empower young people and train them in civic participation and accountability. We want them to be able to protect their rights for their future. And of course, all of her works have earned her very well-deserved accolades, including the Whitley Award in 2010 and National Geographic's Awards for the Leadership in Conservation in 2020. Angela Maldonado has done a lot of work and continues to do a lot of work. It's amazing to see how she continues to push and really mentor others to step up to be Indigenous leaders themselves. Oh, so there you go. If you have any comments or thoughts or additional information or requests or just want to say hello, please do so. We love those. You can email us at stuffmediamomstuff@iheartmedia.com. You can message us on Instagram or TikTok at Stuff Mom Never Told You. We have a book out, which you can buy at stuffyoushouldreadbooks.com or at your local bookstore. We have a Tee Public store now with an amazing t-shirt of Anney as Disco Luke, which you should absolutely check out. Thanks, as always, to our super producer, Christina, executive producer, Maya, our contributor, Joey, and again, shout out to my internet-less co-host, Anney. I miss you, girl. Stuff Mom Never Told You is a production of iHeartRadio. For more podcasts from iHeartRadio, you can check out the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you listen to your favorite shows.